whether it's creating shows, writing shows, executive producing shows, directing shows, voice acting in shows, or watching other people's shows and giving notes on said shows, our next guest is probably the busiest person at Lucasfilm and possibly the only one in the office that can tell you the play-by-play for every moment of the Penguins' first Stanley Cup win from memory, Dave Filoni. What's up, wow. Dave? This is cool. I'm glad that we have, like, sanctioned time to speak because I haven't seen you in months.
I never see you anymore.
I know,
we're
crazy.
Both so busy. It's crazy.
Yeah. What's it like being the busiest person at Lucasfilm?
I think we're all busy at Lucasfilm. There's so much stuff we're doing, but it's all very exciting.
Yeah.
I'm glad for it, but, you know, my life is definitely busier now than it's been in a while, which is good. And we'll see a lot of that tomorrow.
Yeah, it's really exciting. You have a really big day tomorrow.
I do.
The Clone Wars panel, Mandalorian. Yeah. I mean,
it'll be fun.
Yeah, your life has probably been kind of insane with switching back and forth between your animated projects and your live action projects. I'd kind of like to know, you know, how those two processes differ and what it's like been trying to balance them.
They differ greatly, but honestly, I was really well prepared by George.
Yeah.
And the way that he taught me to think of animation and the way that he always referred to it as a shoot and the way we shot Clone Wars, which was with digital sets and digital cameras and to get coverage and edit it like a live action film, because he was a live action director, it really prepared me in a lot of ways, in ways that I wouldn't have been otherwise. But, I mean, the biggest bonus, too, is I get to work with Jon Favreau. And Jon is so knowledgeable. Yeah, for Jon. And he's been another great mentor to me and showed me a lot of the ropes. And honestly, he and I are just having a really great time working on Star Wars.
Yeah, you guys seem to be, you know, somewhat kindred spirits creatively. So tell me what it's like, you know, collaborating with him again.
It's fun. I mean, most of Star Wars is getting together with somebody else that likes Star Wars, and you
and
talk about,
out.
We like these things about Star Wars, and then we put them in a show. And it seems really kind of selfish because you're like, well, these are things I like. But luckily, it turns out a lot of people like the same stuff about Star Wars. And I think you just have to keep it fun and be honest about what you like. And then I, of course, bring a lot of what George taught me to the table and try to make sure that that follows through. And but it's been really fun. I mean, I've been, next year will be 15 years I've worked for Lucasfilm, and
that's wild.
Still enjoying it every day.
You know, it's funny, you know, getting to know all kinds of people inside Lucasfilm and hearing how long they've been with the company and that kind of investment and that kind of longevity is something that I don't think you see very often.
Yeah.
How have things changed for you over those past 15 years?
Well, I think I know what I'm doing now. I don't, in the beginning, I wasn't so sure. I mean, it just changed a lot. I mean, I've gone from being one of the really newer, younger people there, but there are people who have worked with Lucasfilm 40 years, 30 years, and I've tried to tap all of them for knowledge, you know, be it Bill George, John Goodson, you know, John Knoll. The list is long of people that have contributed to Star Wars over the years, and I tried to use everybody there as a resource. So I think now, I think people at Lucasfilm and ILM know more of what I do and what I can offer as a storyteller. And so now I'm working with different groups, not just the animation groups. So I work more company-wide than I have before, which is fun.
Yeah, that's amazing. I mean, it's amazing how, you know, animation has gotten such a prominent place, not only just in Star Wars, but in just, you know, the media mix in general. You know, you just came off of your Rebels Remembered panel a little while ago, and Rebels was such an important part of my time at Lucasfilm, and such an important, I mean, we've got like Heras and Ahsokas and Sabines all over the place. You know, it's such an important thing for so many people.
Yeah.
You know, what did it mean to you to close off that series in the way that you were able to?
It was fantastic. You know, getting to tell the complete story of Star Wars Rebels from start to finish, really controlling that narrative, bringing characters to a proper conclusion, testing a lot of things that I'd learned over years and, you know, putting them to effect was really fun and gratifying. And you hope that you tell a story that resonates with fans and just people generally in their lives. And I think from today that we could have a panel that really wasn't showing any new content, but it's just about saying, hey, we all liked this, we all enjoyed it, let's get together and talk about it, because normally I can't talk about anything.
Right.
So it's fun to be in a panel where I can talk about something, unlike Clone Wars Tomorrow, where I'll barely
right,
say
yeah,
anything.
All that caginess is reserved for tomorrow. So let's talk about bringing back the Clone Wars. I mean, it's obviously such an amazing thing for so many fans out here. You know, they've been wanting it, and they're looking forward to it. I know that panel is highly anticipated. What's your mindset and what's your feeling of being able to bring that series back?
That's a big deal. It was a big deal to do Clone Wars again, not just, you know, personally, but it was very difficult because there are so many people that had moved on that worked on the original. And so the group of us that are still around that had made Clone Wars had to really, in the beginning, sit down and talk to the new team of people and say, this show is not like Rebels. It's a very different show. They're both Star Wars, but in all honesty, like, the scale of Clone Wars is massive. You have many, 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 many clones fighting many, many, many battle droids. That's just something the audience is used to. And I wasn't gonna do it again unless we could do it authentically and the way we used to do it, but also the improvements, some things we learned making Rebels, some things I've learned just being around. And I do think we have achieved that. I'm very excited by what we're doing, and ending it is really important to me. It's not something that I would want to prolong doing. I don't want to do many episodes of it personally, but I want to finish out things that I started. But I think that, I mean, let's be honest, one of the main reasons we brought it back is because people wanted to see it. And for that, I'm very grateful. So
with all the time passed, you know, since Clone Wars ended the first time and when you're bringing it back now, what are some of the lessons that you're bringing to the table this time around?
In Clone Wars?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think you just improve and improve. Hopefully in life, you just get better at things you do and you do trial and error. And so I think that there are some things that I did in Rebels that definitely affected some things that I was doing in Clone Wars, and I had to go back in and retool some of the stories, but I think it worked out to its advantage, actually. I just applied a lot of the knowledge I have as a director. I've been applying actually some things to it I learned from John about live action and storytelling, and I've brought that into Clone Wars too. So I'm hoping it's the very best of what we're capable of doing, certainly what I'm capable of doing, and that we end on a bang. We'll see.
I hope so. I have nothing but the utmost faith. So let's switch channels here and talk about The Mandalorian a little bit, because that is something that, that's something that has surprised me, because at first I wasn't sure if that was a story that I was going to be super interested in it, but now the more I learn about it, the more I see, I'm like, oh my God, yes, I need this. You know, when you're approaching this story, how has your thought process or your, you know, your workflow changed? I mean, it's a completely different world, but you're still telling stories, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it's all Star Wars to me, so it's just, you know, I just kind of check where am I in the timeline to make sure I'm dealing with the right elements, and then I work from there. And I have a fantastic collaborator in John, you know, and a lot of it is just a disgusting story with him. So I won't go into detail. We'll save, you know, a lot of that for tomorrow and the excitement tomorrow, but I'm very excited about it. I've been really, the reason I got curious about doing live action was because I worked with George, and he would explain it at length, and I got really interested in it. And Kathy knew I was interested in it when she came on board, and you know, I think we found a really good place for me to land to you know, contribute in a meaningful way. So I'm excited about that. And you know, I'm very actually thankful too, because I feel fans have really supported the creative things I've done in Star Wars. I think that, you know, that community is very strong, and I feel like, you know, you guys know I give you everything I've got, and I get that in return, and I think the voice of fans has really helped propel what I've done career-wise, so thank you guys. I really appreciate that very much. Really do.
So amazing. I mean, the stories that you've contributed to Star Wars have changed a lot of people's lives in here, so thank you. You know, I know we're all really looking forward to what you have coming up, but I'd love to hear, you know, of all of the things coming down the Star Wars pipeline, like, what are you most excited about?
Oh, it's hard to say. I mean, because now I work on multiple things, and if I say one thing, the one show people
can't
say you don't
favorites.
Love me, and so I can't compete between them. I mean, I'm excited about all of it. I mean, I guess personally, getting to fulfill the ending of Clone Wars is a really big deal for me. So I am, and I've taken that on, and I am very excited about that. But I'm excited about tomorrow. You know, I've got a couple projects, and you know, I'm very proud of the team of Resistance and what they've been able to do.
Yep.
So, you know, I think Star Wars has so many different avenues now and so many different things that we could do creatively to reach, you know, different types of fans. There seems to be no limit to it. It's the thing I learned on Clone Wars and learned, you know, was that we could tell so many different types of stories. Star Wars is very flexible that way. It's a vast galaxy of characters and experiences and stories that it seems to be limitless, and you know, we're definitely proving that.
Yeah, well, super excited to get a chance to talk to you for the first time in
months. It is,
months.
It's so
good
fun,
to see you.
Such a casual, personal conversation,
well,
private, between us.
Well, we'll have to catch up again tomorrow
else.
After your, like, very, very busy day.
We will. We'll grab lunch.
We will be right back with more Star Wars Show live from Star Wars Celebration in Chicago. Don't go anywhere.